Hey there everybody, it's Drew here today, and I'm going to take you through a quick tutorial. The goal of this is I want to show you how to insert an image into the signature area of your email. So, you know, when you read the email and you get down to the bottom and it says sincerely or talk soon or all the best or warm regards, and then there can be an image. The entity I'm going to use as an example today is real, and they're a local chamber of commerce, and they're getting started with email marketing. And we are going to add a particular logo. And for them, the idea behind adding an image to the signature specifically is to promote all the sponsors that help keep their operations going every day. So it's a win-win. They send out emails and they also promote awareness of their sponsors. So let's get going here. Here's Constant Contact. I'm going to go to login. I'm just going to walk you right through all of it. Thank you, browser, for remembering my login and password. Now, if you have another type of email service provider, ActiveCampaign or Mad Mimi, or, you know, I mean, there's dozens and dozens and they're always coming out. You can follow along too, because there's only so many ways to do this. I mean, every one of these is going to have an area where you update settings and you update, for instance, your email signature. So I'm going to start with Constant Contact. I'm going to log in just to get everyone on the same page, no pun intended, just to get everyone on the same area. I'm going to click the home button. Now, once you're there, go all the way over here and click my settings. It's like the universal symbol for my settings, right? The little gear, the little cog. So once you're in there, you're going to find signature information. This area right here, it's the second box. It's like a blue box in here. And then edit signature info is exactly what you're looking for. You're going to click that. Think of it like a template. You only have so much you can change in here, and that's a good thing. So right here we have signature image. We have two options here. I'm going to quickly talk about the image URL. Most of you won't worry about this. Every image out there on the internet, if you see it on a website, it has an image URL. It might be website.com/images/vacation.jpg. Every image out there on the internet has an image URL. So if you wanted to do that, if you wanted to call it in from somewhere else, you could do that there. We're going to do what I think most people are going to be in the same boat. You're going to be putting an image in your image library within your email service provider, within Constant Contact. So let's go here and click this. It says select or change the image. As soon as I click that, this is going to come up. It's a pop-up box. You see over in the top right, it says upload file. We're going to upload a file, and I've prepped my windows and my files for you here before I got started on the video. I'm going to switch over. Okay, now all I'm doing on a Mac is this, you know, command tab, but on a PC I think it's alt or option tab. But all I'm doing is I'm switching over to the window that I have. You can also scoot the window out of the way, and I have a window right here, and I have a folder, a directory, just a folder full of standard media. So here's where I store all of the client logos. So I'll do email, signature, chamber. I might try and in some instances, if I took a few more minutes with this, plug in another keyword or two. But I'm going to drag and drop this into the window. Before I do, I'll try and be thorough here. Remember, you can also, it says drag and drop photos. A lot of email service providers are going to do the same thing, are going to say the same thing. They're going to give you an option or browse your computer to upload. You can navigate to the file if this is intimidating to you. But I'm going to go ahead and drag and drop that image right into there. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is I have this text that is prepared for me, and I'm going to enter that into the description, and I'm going to do that here. Now, why would I do that? Well, think of it like this. Some devices have some kind of hindrance or some kind of obstacle where they don't show email images. You don't want to be stuck in one of those times where here's this device and I'm not seeing images. I'm seeing like maybe the little broken links, or I'm seeing maybe just, you know, it's just not serving up the images. Is as long as you have description text, or some call it alt text, alternative text, you would see a description of what that is. So this is just adding a description, some text in there, and I have chosen our valued 2015-2016 sponsors, our chamber sponsors. So I've done that here. There's the full name. I guess this is another opportunity where I can name the file differently. There's a folder in there. There's some other options in here. I'm just going to stick with the basics, and I've uploaded the image. I've changed the description. And now let's go ahead and say upload files. Okay. Success. You have uploaded one file. No matter what system you're using, you should see that. And I will say done. And indeed, there is the image. And I will go ahead and say the last step in this, just think of it like you're reading left to right, top to bottom, right at the bottom, at the very bottom right, there's insert. I'm going to say insert, and you can see that current selection, look at that, images, email, dash, SIG, dash, chamber, dash, 2015, dash, 16. Okay, that is it. I know, even without a preview, I know that that is the name of my file. I know that this was successful. The last place I'm going to go is click save, and done deal, right? All right, well, that's going to take care of it for this Hudge Huddle. This is Drew Hudgens. Again, it's a Hudge Huddle is the place where business leaders and visionaries and their teams can come and learn more about how to get found, get picked, and getting that to happen again and again. And if you feel like this video has really walked you through this process, that, you know, sometimes it's just we get confused or we get a little scared. Oh, it's in there somewhere. I don't know where. If you feel like this can help someone else, especially on Constant Contact on that platform, it is a very popular platform. Go ahead and share this with them, and hopefully it'll help them out too. Leave any comments, good or bad, and I will see you in the next video.